here's hoping that sale shows up in Bogota. That's our new spinnaker. We made it through customs with the sail.
Amazing.
We were so worried about this. First it made it, and then we made it through customs. They didn't even ask.
So we just got pulled over by the cops at the airport because apparently they thought that our car and driver, because it's white, looked like an Uber, because Uber is illegal in all of Colombia. However, we took an Uber in Cartagena.
It was awesome.
A bunch of times. We didn't know that we were breaking the law. This is vela. Vela for bolero. We have our spinnaker. Now we have one more plane flight to get that thing to Cartagena.
Heading out in Bogota tonight. This is a little shocking to us. Bogota looks like New York City. Fancy people, fancy shops and restaurants, three malls right here in the downtown. And every American restaurant and store you could ever imagine.
An exciting day of touring in Bogota and the countryside. We have a surprise visit to a coffee plantation.
We're in the town of Zipacón. Zipacón?
Oh yeah, all the different towns in Colombia have one special thing, and it's that from the center,
the square.
You have the square. They all have squares.
Yeah.
And in the square, you will find every time two things. The first one, a church.
Right.
Always, there's gonna be a church in the square, and the mayor's office. That's it.
And it's a great story because. He became a lawyer and went to work for a big family office in Bogota, and the family decided to start a coffee growing business, and his boss brought him a cup of coffee one day and he took one sip and he decided he wasn't going to be a lawyer anymore. He was going to work on the plantation in the coffee business.
That was it. Coffee changes your life. Hopefully you will have a sip today and that's it. You're going to be working at the
farm. Know. Maybe I'll be working here.
Yeah, I know.
We might quit cruising and just live on the farm after this.
I think it's going to happen.
I was hoping to get to wear some badass boots.
Well, first of all, welcome to La Palma en Tucán.
Thank you.
So that relationship, that symbiosis that exists between the palm and the toucan, it's the name of us, La Palma y el Tucán. But it also is our neighbors and us. For the coffee itself to be sustainable and for show them that this is possible. That you can also live through coffee and have really good things about it.
You get your crops from 87 farms.
Exactly. We get our cherries from...
Your cherries from 87 farms.
From 87 farms.
So, and is your coffee expensive? Is it inexpensive?
It is expensive, but in a different way. It is expensive, but not in the price, but in the experience itself. Our coffee tree.
Ah.
Right? This coffee tree that we have in here.
Can I touch it?
Yeah, of course. You can touch it. You can feel it. In here, in Coffee and Adventures, we want you to participate in it. And that's the way the experience we have in here at the hotel. So this is your farm. If you want to go running naked through the trees, it's up to you, you know?
Do you want to go running naked through the trees?
Right.
Stick to the coffee?
Maybe later, yeah.
Stick to the coffee?
Yeah, stick to the coffee, right?
These trees are big.
You gotta try it out.
Mine came out beautifully.
Just put it in your mouth. Yeah.
Oh, put this in your mouth?
Mm-hmm.
I'm putting the coffee in my mouth.
You chew it?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Suck it.
Suck it.
And don't swallow
this is
it.
Really expensive coffee. They, no. got, they got a whole team of suckers
Why?
Over there.
I wanted to give it back.
Wow, a sweet. We may get Lenny to start drinking coffee before the end of this.
Are you sure you used to be an attorney?
How long did it take to pick these?
¿Cuánto te demoras haciendo esto?
The tree? To pick it off the tree.
4 hours.
Oh, 4 hours for this much.
Uh-huh.
Right. 4 hours, okay. And then 15 minutes to go through and sort it right here.
Exactly. So what they're picking, it's they're picking the really ripe.
These are the good ones.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Entonces nosotros lo que sacamos es solo de
what they
la
take out, it's the wrong ones.
Those are the best, okay.
Ya no.
Gotcha.
Felipe gave us a great tour of the wet mill. He explained how quality cherries were again sorted and depulped before they went to the drying beds.
For me, drying process is the most important thing in coffee. Because in here, what you have developed through all the different stages behind comes into an end.
Right.
That's a lot of coffee. A lot of boutique coffee.
Felipe explained how boutique coffee has to be zero defects. So here you'll see when they go through bean by bean to hand sort out anything that isn't perfect.
Right, so that's no good.
That's not good. This one's not good.
So, but would like Folgers would let this go through and make coffee out of it? and you guys?
I cannot tell you. I cannot tell you that. Our lab.
What the heck is this?
Wow.
This looks like something out of James Bond.
Yeah, cool.
Is this the highest end coffee farm on planet Earth? The lab. The secret lab. Well, it's kind of a nice lab. Look at the look at the deck.
Let me see.
Look at the deck.
Wow.
And the deck is overlooking the coffee plants. So this is what they call the cupping process. I've never heard of this, didn't know it existed. And you know I drink a lot of coffee.
So the biggest parts are what you want to, the first notes that you want to figure out its kind of taste. So for example, like something fruity, or if you feel like it's floral, and then you'll see like jasmine-like, lavender-like, hibiscus.
Let's start with the first thing first. We're going to go through each step of the cupping, right?
One cup of coffee. Just drop by to let you know that I'm leaving you tomorrow.
Let me show you how to do this. Eyes closed. No idea. And Lenny and I have never done this, so it was very hard for us. It was hard to pick out the different notes and flavors. We're better at rosé. We are at coffee. And you really want to make that noise.
No, just try it. Come on.
That was my first one. You're gonna like the flavor, Ben.
Sorry.
So they're sitting back in the cup. I'm drinking mine. That's what I do at wine tastings also.
Yeah, we just drink them.
I don't spin the cup for wine tastings. Documented cupping. No, we've been traveling for a year and a half, and this is one of today is probably the best day I've had in all of the experience we've had in 15 countries and everything.
So Felipe's taking us to their own restaurant. And they pulled our vegetables and everything.
For real farm to table.
Yeah, farm to table. We're actually on the farm and we're going to the table. Of course, they have their own river. Wow. Look at the view.
So now we're at their private restaurant in this private coffee plantation. And we're sitting at a table that is just a big log. And the coffee tour. Now it's time to really drink the coffee.
So,
with the award-winning barista.
With the award-winning barista, Lisa.
After lunch, Lisa gave us a wonderful presentation on all the different types of coffee and how to make it. It was truly fascinating. And then we got to taste a lot of coffee, and I even got to try my hand.
Mm-hmm. So what I like to do and encourage people is that you want a, kind of like a wider stance. And you want.
This is awesome.
Yeah.
She is telling us the coffee stance.
Yes.
I've never heard of that.
It's important.
It's awesome.
It's very important.
Now we're testing the espresso, and I have to slurp as loud as I can.
Slurp. Okay.
Not that loud.
Was that not loud?
Sorry, no, that was good.
I thought that was such a good slurp.
Okay.
Here we go.
Welcome to coffee making.
Here we go.
Hold on a second.
Welcome to coffee making 101.
I want to show you something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I got my tamp down.
Yeah, that feels kind
you
of
see
a
that?
Fun.
Okay.
All right. Here's your towel. So,
hold on.
First thing.
Remember you always wanted one of those? Yeah.
Hold on. I got to put the towel behind me here. That look good, man?
Yeah, good. It looks good.
So now, let's pull that off. And there is my first espresso. Cheers. Oh, it's way better than yours.
All right, there's a method. It's called high and slow, bring down low, increase the flow. So I'm going to start my initial pour here.
Am I getting tested on that?
I'm going to bring it high, high and slow. When it's getting a little bit fuller, I'm going to bring it down low. I'm going to increase the flow.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. She made a freaking flower. Did you mean to do that?
Of course I meant to do that, but you're making...
Look at that.
That's amazing.
It is a flower of... She is the master barista.
She is.
That is...
They have 9 of these cabins on this plantation. Yeah. And they're just one bedroom bath cabins for like agro-tourism. And look at the view from the bed. Looking up the jungle and the mountainside.
Not really.
That was the best day ever.
Okay, yeah, let me put those
indescribable.
Thank you.
Can you take that?
Yes, you warned us.
You said it's going to be a great day.
I told you it was going to be amazing.
It was amazing. Your guests are going to be so happy when they come to visit here. We are so excited right now.
Beautiful.
We are in Simon Bolivar Plaza, which is the capital of Colombia. This is where it all happens.
So it's a tradition. Every Sunday, they come out and they ride bikes around this plaza in this whole area. They shut down the streets.
One of these is the Presidential Palace. It's early in the morning on Sunday. We don't have a guide right now, but this is, and then here you've got more government buildings, and here you've got the cathedral right there. I mean, just beautiful. The government building back in the late 80s, early 90s, when the government was at war with the drug cartels, one of the rebel groups called K-19 or whatever drove an army tank through the side of the government building and tried to set it on fire because they were fighting with the government about the fact that the government wanted to allow extradition for criminals to the United States. This is really interesting to me because I, if you read my blog, I read a 300-page textbook about 200 years of Colombian governmental history. Don't ask why, but I was fascinated by it. And everything took place right here, so this is awesome to be here. So Simon Bolivar kind of made Colombia happen. Independence. Created the country. Separated from Venezuela. I don't know if you can see on camera how beautiful this church is. Oh, we're going to check it out.
Wow, qué bonito.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, that's a whole different architectural style.
Amazing.
Absolutely beautiful. Many says that's Baroque.
But I could be wrong.
I don't think she really knows that. It just sounds like the right thing to say. And I can tell you I'm Baroque after paying our bill at the Four Seasons. We just need our spinnaker to get on one more plane.
I know, we're so close.
So goodbye, Bogota. So American charged us $450 for the oversized bag, and Avianca charged
zero.
Nothing. Back in Cartagena. And we're really hoping our spinnaker is under that plane right now. And it's 87 degrees as opposed to 45 in Bogota. So that's nice. Can you help us go to the boat?
He was
okay.
High on intellectualism. I've never been there, but the brochure looks nice.
Our spinnaker made it to Cartagena. So I want you to know this thing was built in South Africa, then they shipped it to Virginia, then they shipped it to Florida to our house. Then we flew with it to Bogota and then to Cartagena, and now it's on the boat.
Every day is a winding road. Get a little bit closer.
We had such a good night in Bogota.
Bogota's awesome.
We're bringing drinks to our room.
We're gonna watch our movie.
I don't know if
I
this
think
is
they
gonna...
call that Netflix and chill.
I don't know.
I don't know what that means though. Actually.
I don't know.
We're gonna have to get the kids to tell us what that means.
I don't know if this video is gonna make it to our video.
Yeah, probably not.
We got back from the coffee plantation and Randy probably had 12 cups of coffee today. He's a little jacked up.